Hi there, Libra. Thank you so much for tuning in, love and light to you here. Thank you so much for connecting and for your dear patience with this reading. Oh my goodness, I've been in the middle of a move. It's been crazy busy. So let's get on with it here for you. Dear Libra, thank you so much all you again for connecting. And let's see what's coming through here for you. February 2019. And this is an overview, thematic, general. I'm hearing June and July. Interesting. Okay, there could be something that's coming through from those months, the summer months, something that you were really focused on. I'm hearing captioning. Okay, interesting. Something that perhaps you were working on. I'm hearing molding, melding as well. It could be related. I'm hearing specifically to matters of community. I'm hearing also collaboration. I'm hearing commitment. Okay, and there could be something that you're thinking about bringing together. Now, I'm hearing source as well, whatever that may mean in particular for number, you know, again, let's get on with it here. And before we do, take a deep breath, Libra. This is a big, I'm hearing, station that you're tuning into here. Wow. There's a focus on specifically what I'm seeing you, Libra, collecting. I'm hearing connecting to, and specifically it can be related to your resources that you see yourself in some shape or form channeling down the line. Again, I'm seeing that there might be a focus on the number six even again, the month of June. Matters that may even extend into the next, I'm hearing, yearly cycle. Okay, interesting. But yet again, this is your January. I'm hearing January. Again, we are in January right now. Your February reading, and please bear with me as it's just crazy here. There's a lot going on. Everything is being kind of put in its place, and the washer's on right now. So again, if you hear a noise, I hope it's not too loud for you. And for those of you who are just tuning in, new watchers here, thank you so much for connecting and tuning in. Loving light to you all. And if you'd like to get notified of when the videos post, for those of you who've been, let's say, following for quite some time and you want to know when exactly the new videos that'll be coming out will be posted, then feel free to click the subscribe button. And right when you click that, there should be a bell icon. Make sure you click that if you would like to get notified of exactly when they post. Okay, Libra, I'm hearing, let's not waste any time. There's a major calling here. I'm hearing announcement as well that you feel, whoa, the High Priestess, spinning, circling, turning, looking into the future. She's mirroring here the Star, and the Magician is in reverse, looking back at the Star. You've got two big players here, the High Priestess and the Magician. I'm hearing it's time to make magic. I'm hearing, and to manifest what our version of gold is. Very interesting here, related to the Temperance card. I'm hearing it has to do with your vision. You could be dealing with a Pisces. They might have a lot of, I'm hearing, gold tones in their eyes. I'm hearing flex here with the Hanged Man coming through as well, and the High Priestess, both associated with the archetype of Pisces. I'm hearing get comfortable here, because it's gonna be a long process of understanding what I'm hearing the underlying motive is with the Hierophant and the Death card. Now the it's interesting, Libra, right before we get into it, I want to say this. It was so interesting before I got right started with your reading. I my phone had dropped. I dropped my phone and there was like this crack in the corner of the screen, and in that moment, and it kind of shattered, in that exact moment, it was this alleviation. Now, this energy came through in the Scorpio reading. I believe it was for, January? I believe it was for January, where there was this shattering of glass in Scorpio's reading, right in the beginning of the reading, and it was that same feeling, Libra, and it was right before that period, there was this feeling of I'm hearing specifically passion, I'm hearing, and the question of what to do with it. Now, if you've been kind of in this state, I'm hearing this lull of how is it that I have this amazing car, I'm hearing this beautiful car, how is it that I'm driving it forward actually, where is it that I want to be taking myself, I'm hearing my things, and all of my, I'm hearing my goodie bags as well, I'm hearing to tote, whatever that may mean in particular for a number of you. Now, I'm seeing that has to do with matters of community, what may also be carried out on an energetic level, spiritually as well, Libra. Now, I'm hearing there is a focus on gratitude. What is it that we are, I'm hearing, shaping our dreams with? I'm hearing envisioning, I'm hearing as well, as the very foundation of the space that we hold. I'm hearing as a vision, but also as a certain form of connection to the community that we see related to this vision. Now, I'm seeing that you see perhaps your vision, let's say what it is that you see you connect with as a dream, as being relevant within even, let's say, a communicative space. Now, there could have been a lot of pressure around this time. Even the past, I'm hearing specifically, again, 6 months to January. I'm hearing January. But June and July, there could have been a lot of pressure, like, build up right until the point of July. January. And leading straight into this period, the question of, well, what is it that I do with this? I understand that the train is gaining momentum. I'm hearing there's traction. And I'm getting that for a number of you, this might be related to writing, speaking, communicating, wanting to really, I'm hearing, relay a message here in a way that I'm hearing, going to really shatter the glass. I'm hearing, and let that balloon fly. Now, the Five of Wands right over here, the Five of Swords, two fives. Libra with the Ace of Swords and the Ace of Wands, you're ready. I'm hearing to tell the world what works for you here. Now, the Mother of Cups looks over into the future. And the devil here is looking down at the High Priestess. Now, perpendicular to the devil is the, I'm hearing the Magician, and it is the Magician that sits right next to this High Priestess, but the devil is right beneath here, the Mother of Pentacles. I'm hearing getting comfortable, getting situated with the Sun of Swords. I'm hearing the Ward, the Ward, W-A-R-D. I'm hearing Ward here with the Sun of Swords. Perhaps a specific message here coming through for a number of you, but there is, I'm hearing a whole lot of pressure. I'm hearing specifically, but in a way of, well, I understand yet again that I have this, I'm hearing, beautiful car. I'm hearing this racehorse as well. Chariot coming through for you. Libra, I realize that I have all of, I'm hearing these acorns, excuse me, Libra, as well. What is it that I want to be really, I'm hearing, carrying them over to? And there could be a focus on travel. You could be kind of traveling around this time of the early months of February. Interesting. Perhaps what it is that you have been, I'm hearing, seeing. Oh, it's so fascinating. I'm seeing like a number of months, okay, that have been, I'm hearing, shoveled out and shoveled in. Interesting. Almost like steps. I'm hearing stops along the way as well. Almost as if it's a sort of timeline strategy, Libra. Now, what it is that you, in a certain way, I'm hearing, saw yourself manifesting over time, in a certain way, is, as I'm getting it, almost like truncated in a certain period of time during this month. So there could be something during the month, let's say even of January, that again came to a point of buildup, and now I'm hearing it's cleaning time. I'm hearing it's the finest hour with the Empress, the Eight of Wands, the Eight of Swords, two eights here. Dear Libra, I'm hearing it's definitely time to tell everyone, I'm hearing again, what it is that we're here to water as the very seed of this vision. I'm hearing this dream of what it is that I stand for, and I'm hearing that I become one with. I'm hearing specifically in nature, for a number of you, strongly, I'm hearing as well, to commemorate here as well with the Strength card. Okay, now, there is a new beginning. You have the Fool sitting at the apex of your spread, and I want to clean up the cards here. The Sun of Cups is looking over at the Empress. The Chariot could be dealing with a Cancer. You could be dealing, I'm hearing, limelight. They could be in the public eye in some shape or form. If you're dealing with a Cancer and you're wondering where they've gone, what they're doing, I mean, if they're doing their homework as well, they're working on, I'm hearing, a certain type of, I'm hearing water filtration system as well. Interesting. They could also be, they could be a channeler. I'm hearing that specifically. They could be working on a certain form of also meditation. I'm hearing Hierophant. I'm hearing strongly. They could be also, they could be working with, I'm hearing, children as well as crystals, okay? In whatever way that may be meant for a number of you, but then they might have a lot of Aquarius. Uranus strongly plays 11th house. Strongly placed Uranus, okay? I'm hearing Jupiter as well. They could be working, again, I'm hearing specifically with children. Okay, and you may be dealing with an Aquarius as well. Now, I'm hearing, do they have children? I'm hearing they might. I'm hearing they might. One second here, Libra. I'm hearing they're listening to their godmother. I'm hearing godmother. I'm hearing godfather as well here with the Empress. Whatever that may mean in particular for number, the Empress is right related to the number three in the major arcana, and is associated with, right, three being the number, let's say, associated with creation. So what might be sort of a focus around this time is, and it can absolutely be your own energy, right, is perhaps being branded, I'm hearing, right now. And this is, I'm hearing specifically for a number of you, a matter of frequency, how it is that perhaps you are, I'm hearing, channeling strongly for a number of you. Could be meditating heavily on what, I'm hearing, what kind of response you want to be giving. I'm hearing what it is that you want to also be, I'm hearing, I'm hearing Gary so strongly here with the Hermit, the Son of Cups, the Ace of Cups, the Two of Cups, the Eight of Wands, the Three of Pentacles. What it is that you are, I'm hearing caring, I'm hearing as well into this new beginning. And it might be energetically, frequentially, what it is, Libra, that you are understanding. I'm hearing, seeing clearly. Okay, now Len, for whenever you, again, there could be a focus on channeling. You might be strategizing something, working even with astrology, timing something. Let's get to the cards and see what comes through, dear Libra. And there could be a number of stages here involved for a number of you. Let's get the cards and see what comes through again. Okay, and I want to open the window. 1 second. Or the blinds, rather. Okay. Libra, Libra, Libra. We're stepping into February. February, February. The second month of the year of 2019. The devil coming through. I'm hearing it's serious business here, even if it means that we're doing things in a completely new way. I'm seeing for a number of you yet again that there is a sense of clearance. I'm hearing clarity here with the Tower in reverse, the High Priestess in reverse, and the Judgment card upright right beneath here, the Tower. Okay, with the Ten of Pentacles in reverse, the Mother of Wands in reverse, the Mother of Swords in reverse. I'm hearing there's a lot of pressure. There's been a lot of pressure, Libra, to come to a point of understanding exactly what I'm hearing specifically, what community we want to be involved in. I'm hearing guiding as well. What is it? I'm hearing, again, channeling or perhaps our resources through, for a number of you, this could be related to funding, where it is that you see you yourself investing in even a certain plot of land. I'm hearing property. There could be a focus and a question of, well, what is the philosophy of that space, even the values. And I want to open the window for real this time, Libra, for real. Okay. We went to the blinds and then now we're going to the window. Okay. All right. I'm hearing listen in, tune in. I'm hearing talk show. I'm hearing talk show, okay, strongly. Now let's, we'll pull all the cards here and the Celtic cross and see what comes through. Pull a card for the deep past, the recent past, the near future, the current state, energetic pathway that leads you into the current state, your advice position, the environment position, the hopes and our fears, and the final outcome position. And right, energy is fluid. It's always a matter of interpretation, personal interpretation, right? Libra, I'm hearing specifically that you are being guided through a certain process for a number of you. I'm hearing Timothy, Tommy. I'm hearing testing. I'm hearing testing here. Okay, I'm hearing with the High Priestess, the Sun of Cups flying out, the Temperance card flying out again. You could be dealing with matters that are related to Sagittarius as well as Pisces. It could be the energy in your very own chart. I'm hearing testing. You're being tested. I'm hearing as well, Libra, strongly on perhaps a certain principle here with the High Priestess and the Fool. I'm hearing faith. I'm hearing fate as well. What does it mean to feel completely in line? I'm hearing aligned with our, I'm hearing concept of love. I'm hearing the paradigm of productivity as well. When we create something, I'm hearing specifically, what does it mean? And I'm setting this Father of Pentacles aside, like so determinately, like I'm hearing specifically, like I'm hearing I'm hearing in the cold here, out in the cold here, the Father of Pentacles and the Six of Pentacles, the Ace of Pentacles in reverse. And the energy I'm hearing is moving towards here, the High Priestess. The focus is being moved towards the High Priestess. Matters related to the 12th house, matters related to even, let's say, the emotional space, the spiritual dimension. I'm hearing astrally, I'm hearing traveling, the Six of Cups, what has a feeling space to it. And the feeling I'm getting for you, Libra, is that, well, you know, I'm hearing the house is not a home until we make it one that I'm hearing shines for us. I'm hearing that we feel that we've created as well. And in what way is that meant? In whatever way, let's say that you feel that you're participating in a certain physical space. I'm hearing the creation of it. A physical, I'm hearing audience as well. In whatever way that might mean for you, the question is, well, it's not a matter of necessarily what the space tells everyone that it's used for. Very interesting. But rather how it is that I am holding the space energetically, I'm hearing, by way of my vision. Now, you're getting really clear, Libra, on what it is that feeds your vision. flying out as the Seven of Swords on the floor. I'm hearing you're waiting on, before you said any, I'm hearing any tones. I'm hearing even frequentially, very interesting. Before you say, yes, I'm moving in that direction. Yes, we're doing this. Yeah, okay, this is the contract. I'm seeing you really having I'm hearing a third eye, I'm hearing Wheel of Vision here with the High Priestess and the Ace of Cups, the Emperor, okay? And there being a very strong focus on matters of manifestation again. And I'm seeing that you're getting very, very aware of even your environment and what moves through it in ways that empower you, that sustain your vitality here with the Ace of Wands. What makes me and pushes me closer to the point of moving in a direction that feeds me, I'm hearing specifically, my creativity, my drive, and what are the things around me that I feel that I need to share? I'm hearing the load of a little bit here, the Father Cups. Again, what might feel like, let's say, pressure, even to communicate what I am feeling in this space that I'm holding. Again, now, for a number of you, this could be related to healing, strongly so. Could be related to counseling as well, mentorship, even a matter of, let's say, sharing. I'm hearing what it is that you might be feeling I'm hearing a depth of emotion. Okay, so there could be a little bit of I'm hearing wielding of the emotional space, so to speak, with the Ace of Cups and the Ace of Wands. There's a lot, again, I'm hearing a lot of pressure. I'm hearing to create. I'm hearing passion. What is it that we love? Okay, and that being a question of direction at this point. Now, the movement I'm hearing in the change happens by way of the forces that I'm hearing ultimately, I'm hearing might be considered destructive in the way of when I realize that I am moving forward. I realize that I am in a certain way moving outside of what has been. Now that really, I'm hearing, causes us to take a step back and contemplate what is the space from which we are creating. What, again, I'm hearing specifically, do I feel the space of before I am there? Okay, and so for a number, you could actually be moving. I'm getting that strongly for a number of you. If you are actually physically moving, it's almost like, well, what space actually do I, can I feel myself in? Okay, it's that kind of feeling. Now, we'll pull a few more cards, and that was not the Celtic Cross. Okay, let's get the Celtic Cross out and see what comes through for your Libra. Oh, gosh, it's been absolutely crazy busy. So, again, thank you for your patience with these readings, Libra. I'm hearing, let me love you, love you. Is that by Mario? I'm hearing grand, whatever that may mean. In particular, for a number of you here, I'm hearing it with the Justice card, the High Priestess. Okay, let's pull the Celtic Cross. I'm hearing Daughter Pentacles as well. Okay. Hearing again, listen in, tune in. I'm hearing traveling. I'm hearing traveling show. The Two of Pentacles coming through in the deep past, Libra, leading into the recent past, the Daughter Swords upright. I'm hearing let them do their research here with the Magician coming through in reverse in the current state. I'm hearing wondering. There's a strong focus here on the Five of Wands in reverse in the advice position. We'll get to that. The Devil's in reverse in the energetic path that leads you into the Magician. Okay, this is a period I'm hearing specifically, Libra, right around the beginning of February, of coming to terms with what we feel is our, I'm hearing, source. I'm hearing our mediumship. I'm hearing as well what it is that we feel we are in a certain way connecting. I'm hearing astrally for a number of you as well. The Three of Wands coming through in your environment. Okay, in the near future is the Tower upright. I'm hearing we'll get to that. I'm hearing the talking point. I'm hearing that comes to boil the water in the pot. Finally, I'm hearing finalement in French. The Two of Wands in reverse in the hopes and fears position, leading you into the Nine of Wands upright. And I'm hearing light as a feather, leading into the Two of Swords, which sits in your energetic pathway that leads you into this space. Now, let's pull one more card, the Five of Swords, leading down into the Nine of Wands and the Justice card in your theme, Libra. I'm hearing it's time. You know what you're talking about this time. I'm hearing as well, in whatever way that might be meant for you, I'm getting that you are coming to terms with what your philosophy is of creation. When you're, let's say, feeling a certain sense of passion, right? Where it's like, and I'm seeing someone who like met someone and they're like, whoa, I don't know. Like when I met them, I'm hearing the 21st of September. Da 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 da. da 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 way. What's that song? Is that by Earth, Wind, Fire? Earth, Wind, Fire, Water? Is it the four elements? Okay. Nonetheless, I don't know what's going on here, Libra, but I'm hearing keep the ball rolling. I'm seeing that there's something that perhaps really, I'm hearing even generated a certain amount of income here, serious income. I'm seeing the number two. I'm hearing a milli here with the two of swords, something that really, again, I'm hearing specifically generated a lot of cash flow for a number of you. And I'm hearing 2,000 here, 2,000 with the two of swords. Now I'm seeing that whatever that is, again, whatever was a source of passion, like you, again, you came across someone or you had some kind of encounter, some kind of experience. I'm hearing session as well, where you just, I'm hearing lit you up. You thought, whoa, I'm hearing this is what it feels like to love what I do. Now that space is priceless, Pisces. I'm hearing strongly, okay? There's a focus on what you are here. I'm hearing specifically manifesting. I'm hearing the gold space of, I'm hearing gold tones again. Now there could be a focus on what you are shaping the space of for, and the energy is moving by so quickly I can kind of barely keep up with my own speed of talk. So if it's going by really quickly for you and you want to slow it down, Libra, you can feel free to do so via the dial at the base of the video. Okay, now let's get into it and take a deep breath. Yes, okay. There is a focus I'm hearing specifically for you, Libra, on what you feel has a very serious place within, I'm hearing, a certain community. I'm seeing you realizing, wow, you know what? I'm hearing connecting a certain, I'm hearing source to a certain doc. Very interesting. I'm seeing someone who feels that I'm hearing medium strongly. You may feel that I have even, let's say, a certain, I'm hearing source of insight. I'm hearing information as well that I feel, and I'm hearing that this is related to spirituality, even guidance, that I am, I'm hearing extending to a certain, even physical space. Like I'm seeing you almost wanting to create a space, Libra, to almost like transport even these, let's say, materials, goods. It could be actual physical products, but I'm seeing that it is related to what eventually will hold the space of a network. Okay, interesting. Now I'm hearing people here are priceless. The concept of people, I'm hearing the personality as well, of the space that you hold in whatever way that might be meant for you, be it how you see yourself as the creator of it, be it how you see yourself as the creator, being related to those who you feel you are connecting to by way of the space, I'm hearing by way of your work. What is it exactly that you feel is the chapter and the lines that are written along it? Now, it's very interesting because if you look at the Nine of Wands, and I know it's going by so quickly, the energy is moving by so quickly for you. I'm hearing Pisces, Capricorn, Sagittarius, and Scorpio. And these might be parts of your very own chart that are coming to light. I'm hearing specifically fruition. I'm hearing so strongly Scorpio, Libra. Let's get onto it though here with the Nine of Wands. If you look at that card, right, there are these lions that line the staircase, right? If you specifically look at it, there are these ledges. I'm hearing steps. I'm hearing ladders and leaders as well. There is a, I'm hearing a grand, I'm hearing ball here. I'm hearing show and affair related here to the Nine of Wands. Whatever that may mean, in particular for a number of you, there could be a focus on the month as well. I'm hearing specifically of September. Okay, there could be a focus here on the month of September. I'm hearing nine strongly related to the month of nine. Okay, now let's move forward though. I'm hearing Scorpio so strongly. I'm hearing don't lose momentum here with what it is that you feel is I'm hearing the water that feeds the I'm hearing the birth. I'm hearing very interesting. I'm almost thinking it's like what is the water in the womb, okay, related here to the Three of Wands. Now if we look at the Three of Wands there, it almost seems as if, right, within the Three of Wands, the shape that it creates and that it molds specifically, I'm hearing frequentially, is almost liquefied, right? It's like, it's almost as if it is like a womb. And the number three again coming through for you, Libra, related to matters of manifestation, creation. Now remember the Empress that came through in the top left-hand corner of your spread, the number three as well, and it was right around here related to the Devil that it now sits in the position of. There is a focus on what you have been, I'm hearing, climbing steadily towards, right? What it is that you have been feeling, I'm hearing, that you are drawing to the surface. For a number of you, this can be an actual birth, but I'm seeing for a number of you that this is related to what you have been feeling and what it is that you've been holding a vision of, focusing so intently on manifesting. Oh my goodness. For a number of you, I'm seeing you having like, I'm hearing gone into almost like a certain, I'm hearing like a paraplegic shock, where you just like, but you almost like you go into shock, and you almost like are, there's this feeling of like, I'm hearing in continuity in whatever way that might be meant for you particularly here, but in the way of like disconnecting from the physical body completely. I'm hearing astral traveling, okay, related here to the tower. Now there's something that perhaps I'm hearing again, you feel that there is a certain tipping point where you're like, okay, I'm hearing this luggage of love, very interesting. I'm seeing someone who's almost encouraging, encouraging their own, I'm hearing acting skills, very interesting, their own, almost like coaching themselves, almost like mentoring themselves, talking to themselves, I'm hearing self-talk, like repetitively, I'm hearing by the book, very interesting, what it is that they have been, seeing themselves carry out. Now, for a number of you, if you've been wanting to work with the public, specifically as it relates to matters of public performance in a creative way. Okay, let's say you were thinking about becoming an actor or an actress, however it is that you reconnect to a certain archetype of a matter of creativity, even let's say music, right? Let's say that you're thinking about becoming a musician, a performer in some kind of way, whatever it may be, a dancer, okay, so on and so forth, even a chef, a culinary, whatever it may be. I'm hearing also teacher, okay, whatever that may mean. Again, in particular for you, I'm seeing that there has been this process of building the, I'm hearing the balloon that you eventually hold in hand to, to light, I'm hearing the stage, very interesting, and I'm seeing you having a certain physical space that is so much of a focus and so related to what you're actually manifesting that it's what you are bringing, I'm hearing, into form by way of the feeling that you hold for what you dream of. Oh, Libra, I'm hearing you're on a mission. Don't let anyone tell you that you're not going forward in it, okay? And I'm seeing that there are perhaps a lot of, I'm hearing forces here, in whatever way that might be meant for you, a lot of, like, almost like, I'm hearing devil's advocate moments where it's like, wow, okay, I can, you know, move forward, and then I hear this, and there's one, it's technically, it can be seen as one jump back, but Libra, I'm hearing specifically, there are a lot of layers to the cake, and there will always be the ice at the top. It's what we see, okay? There are a lot of steps here, a lot of stages. I'm hearing 5, 5, 5. That's 15, reducing to 6. Okay, there are a lot, again, I'm hearing specifically, there are a lot of layers here that perhaps you feel you're building. Again, I'm seeing someone building. Again, I'm hearing it's not meant to be a simple story. And it's, I'm hearing, one that we may be writing. For a number of you, if you're a writer, I'm seeing that this is something that has been building. Okay, now let's get a few more cards out and see what comes through for you, Libra. Now I'm seeing that there, again, right around the beginning of the month, there could have been a little bit of pressure, like, oh, you may have been feeling like you needed to talk to someone, there might have been something that you felt like, I'm hearing conversate about, really, I just feel like I need to talk about this, I'm hearing commitment strongly for a number of you. It could be related to children, home life, family, the Chariot in reverse, right of the Hangman in reverse, there could be a Pisces involved, there could be a strong focus on meditation for a number of you. If you're thinking of making a decision, thinking of communicating, I'm seeing that you're really counseling, I'm hearing your higher self, very interesting with the Hanged Man. For a number of you, meditation is, I'm hearing the ozone layer here for the letter that we're going to be writing. Interesting. I'm seeing for a number of you, I'm hearing Taoism. I'm hearing Taoist. I'm hearing really getting into, I'm hearing the beat. I'm seeing someone with like headphones on and they're like, I'm hearing I Am Iron Skillet. I'm not sure what that, I think that's a band, right? Okay. Eight of Wands upright, right over the Mother of Swords. Let's get a few more cards out and see what comes through. I'm hearing unearthing the chandelier here with the Two of Cups coming through, right at the base of this Eight of Wands and Mother of Swords. It's time, Libra, I'm hearing it's time to let them know. I'm hearing that we are, I'm hearing really serious about this love match related to the Mother of Wands. It could be a financial partnership as well for Libra, but I'm seeing that there is a focus on what you are, and the Devil coming through right at the base of the Lovers. Okay, Lovers in reverse flying back into the Five of Wands upright to light one more match here, whatever that may mean, in particular for a number of you, the Three of Swords at the base of the Five of Wands, and the Lovers are flying back into the Two of Cups. Always take it as you will, Libra, right? The energies can be moving through in so many different ways, and this is a general reading of words, right? So it can, right, speak to, it can sort of be relevant in a number of ways for a number of people, okay? And let's give the ladder here to the financial, I'm hearing, officer, manager, the Father of Pentacles, the Magician. There's something that perhaps you feel you need to release, even as information, something that you're waiting on the release of. I'm hearing announcement, information. It could be related to someone abroad. It could be related to a company abroad. Finances, I'm hearing, again, financial manager. I'm hearing, I'm hearing Fiona. I'm hearing strongly. Frederick. I'm hearing strongly with the Magician and the Mother of Pentacles. I'm hearing here with the Father of Pentacles. There could be someone who is stepping down from a position and almost like transferring it over to someone else. There could be something that you are wondering. I'm hearing who's going to be taking a certain role. I'm almost getting this feeling of like a company that just, I'm hearing, lost a hire or a hiree, and they're now like rehiring, and everyone in that company is kind of wondering, well, what's the suit and the tie and the talk and what's going on? I'm hearing, where's Larry? I'm hearing, and where's his letter here to the president? I'm hearing as well. And what exactly I'm hearing specifically, Libra, I'm hearing left behind as well here. And I'm seeing someone, let me say it this way, Libra, I'm seeing someone like wondering, waiting on there to be some form of a change, a major change, a transformation. There is perhaps a piece of news, even a contract that you're waiting on someone to come through with. I'm hearing contract here strongly. I'm hearing singleton here with the Mother of Swords, Three of Wands. Okay, now, but there, I'm hearing lease letter. I'm hearing office again. It could be related to investment, funding, financials. I'm hearing again, Fiona. I'm hearing Fiona strongly. I'm hearing Fedora as well here with the Fool. I'm hearing challenging the Moose to a duel here with the Father of Pentacles. Okay, and it is depicted right as a moose on the Father of Pentacles card. Now, Libra. I'm seeing that, I'm hearing the Fool can't be afraid of some climbing here with the Devil. And if you look at the Devil, right, the Devil is associated with the archetype of Capricorn, Saturn, matters of the 10th house, career, what's carried out in a public way, working with matters that are related to, I'm hearing specifically the honesty of judgment in whatever way that might be meant for you. It could be an overlap between even, let's say, the 7th house in Capricorn. If for a number of you, let's say you've got Saturn even in the 7th house, for a number of you, whatever that may mean in particular for you, there could be a focus on that kind of coming through. It could be related as well to legal matters. Okay, nonetheless, there is a focus, as I'm getting it, on what I'm hearing has I'm hearing the power and the drive to move. I'm hearing through the mountain. I'm hearing also to move mountains here with the Fool and the Devil. How does it, let's say, and I'm seeing them as working with one another, the Fool and the Devil, almost there being this feeling of like the Devil's like, look, Fool, okay, I'm hearing you've got to learn how I'm hearing money works. I'm hearing that specifically for Nora. You could be like working with a certain I'm hearing stockbroker here. I'm hearing market. I'm hearing analysis here with the Devil, almost like someone who gives you a certain I'm hearing ounce of gold and tells you that I'm hearing it's gonna hurt your tummy if you eat it. Very interesting. Okay, whatever that may mean. Like, I'm seeing someone being like don't, I'm hearing don't just, I'm hearing also spend all your money. I'm hearing that specifically for a number of you. I'm hearing gelt, like chocolate coins. I believe that that's in believe that's in the, like the dreidel and maybe the chocolate coins. Okay, if anybody has any insights, please comment, Libra. Okay. All right, a few more cards here for you right as we trail out and see what comes through. I'm hearing there's a sudden break. I'm hearing of honesty. I'm hearing clarity. What is it that we are? I'm hearing feeling so connected to here with the Mother of Cups, the Judgment card. For you may be thinking, I'm hearing I gotta be honest with them. I'm hearing I wanna talk to them here with the world. I wanna tell them that I'm hearing turning around here my wheel, the world. I'm hearing and its spokes. Interesting. If you look at the Three of Pentacles, it almost looks like spokes to a wheel in the world, right? Almost as if it's a wheel. The Daughter of Wands at the apex of the spread with the Daughter of Pentacles, the Temperance card. I'm hearing someone is wanting to make a major, I'm hearing audition here for a number of you. We're talking like, I'm hearing in front of millions. I'm hearing of people. I'm hearing a really big audience. For a number of you, this might be something that you are already, I'm hearing in talks of. I'm hearing conversation about. It might be related to a, I'm hearing chairholder. Okay. Somebody who perhaps is, I'm hearing related to a certain radio station. Okay. Somebody who might have word of or in within a certain group. I'm hearing network, company, somebody who you feel has the letter that's gonna get everyone in the front door, okay, so to speak. It's like it could be also a skill in I'm hearing writing, I'm hearing conversations. Well, I'm seeing someone perhaps, it could be your own energy, absolutely. It could be networking around this time, Libra, strongly. Now the Chariot sits at the very base of your spread. Again, where is it that we're moving? Again, not just because we physically are moving to that physical space, but because we have already, I'm hearing, managed it. I'm hearing with our assets in our mind. I'm hearing in our vision. We have everything here, I'm hearing specifically, that tells us that the world is working with us here to create the space. Now, there's been a lot, again, I'm hearing specifically, a lot of practice and a lot of pressure here with the Daughter of Cups, Two of Cups, Ace of Pentacles, the Lovers. I'm hearing we've been telling them. I'm hearing love stories every night here. And it could be you with you, right, Libra? How is that, again, you're talking to yourself through this process, and I'm seeing for a number of you that there's been a lot of self-talk here, a lot of really, I'm hearing positive reinforcement, where you're not just carrying the bucket that holds your, I'm hearing seeing eyeglasses, I'm not sure what that might mean, but I'm seeing someone like carrying their goods, like carrying it with like a bucket of like their assets, and it's like, no, I'm hearing I'm the magician, but I don't have a hat that I keep everything in, okay? I am the magician and I wear everything that I am going to audition with. I'm hearing it specifically in that way. And if you are auditioning here for a major role, Libra, with the Fool coming through in between the Father of Wands and the Five of Wands, I'm seeing that it is your advantage to wear your best suit here. When you're tailored with the tie that tells you what time it is. Very interesting. Okay, now this energy came through. Yes, in the Scorpio reading. Now always take it as you will. This came through, it was months ago. I believe it was in November. Okay, perhaps even October. Oh, before October. Oh, was it? August or September, it came through in one of the Scorpio readings. Oh my goodness, it was like a tie that could tell time. And it had some kind of, I'm hearing like receiver on it. I'm not sure, I'm almost seeing like a really like advanced tailoring of even, I'm hearing specifically time here with the Fool. It could be some form of, okay, I'm seeing it in this way. If you are, I'm hearing specifically auditioning, it could even be for, even I'm hearing pitching for investment, and you're like, okay, look, I'm hearing this is the future. Do I bring it with me? I'm hearing to the table to talk to them about it, or do I kind of like test, I'm hearing the waters, and I'm seeing that jumping in with a big splash, and again, always take it as you will, Libra, always heed your personal intuition. I'm hearing meditate on it. If you're wondering how you feel that it would be most conducive for you, let's say, to present something, I'm seeing that meditation, I'm seeing someone like before they move into like a certain space, as well. Really meditate, Libra. I'm seeing that you will find every focal point here in that state of awareness, okay? And I'm seeing that, again, if you're thinking about writing something, even relaying something, presenting something, pitching something, auditioning, I'm seeing for a number of you, though, that there is a focus on, and it may be highly advantageous to stand, I'm hearing, on the highest, I'm hearing leaf on the ladder here. Very interesting, related to the Fool. It's almost like, what brought me here? I'm hearing specifically for an overview, what brought me here? I'm hearing contestant, final contestant. What brought me here? To showcase my talents. Now that has been a certain seasonal, I'm hearing, state of transformation. Now what it is that I see now naturally culminating is what I want to, I'm hearing, be representing here. I'm hearing to also, I'm hearing, bring to the table for discussion. And I'm seeing that there's a little bit of a space of, like, you know, let's say questioning, well, how far, I'm hearing, how far in do we go here with the Daughter of Cups? How much do we divulge here, I'm hearing, as well, of the pattern here that we hold here with the Justice card? What exactly, and it could be related to a contract for a number of you, there could be a little bit of, like, negotiation, wondering, oh, what do I start with? What foot do I start with? How do I step into the room? And if that is so, I'm getting that you might, I'm hearing lacquer here, lacquer with the Fool. You might be, I'm hearing lacquer, like L-A-Q-U-E-R, like lacquer. Almost like a glaze here with the Fool. I'm seeing, again, like, totally, like, I'm hearing, like, suit, tie, tailored, okay? Which is, like, a very Libra thing. I've got a lot of Libra in your chart. You know how to make everyone look, okay? We'll put it like that. But, I'm hearing related to the question of love, I'm hearing as well. Very interesting, okay? And this, again, can be happening energetically, and always take it as you will. I'm just kind of channeling what's coming through, not in any particular way, right? But I'm hearing Capricorn knows here what the conversation is about. The Father of Pentacles in reverse here, right beneath the Hanged Man and mirroring here, the Devil in reverse. Now I'm hearing someone's got, I'm hearing, some distance to keep here. There could be a certain focus within a certain space that is not being completely addressed. It could be really, I'm hearing, completely, I'm hearing, communicated through. It could be related to the financial side. I'm almost seeing, like, people coming together in a certain room, and they're talking about a lot of stuff. And I'm hearing specifically the letters, and I'm hearing lease management, but they're not yet talking about, I'm hearing, the heavyweight investment. I'm hearing, it could be related to, like, down the line. I'm seeing that there might be a focus on, well, what is the point of, I'm hearing, friction, but I'm seeing it as, I'm hearing focus at this point, and then the question being, well, what is it that will carry out down the line? Could be, like, still, still, I'm hearing, being processed. I'm hearing packaged. It could be also materially, physically. It's something that is perhaps not fully, I'm hearing, depreciated as well. There is perhaps a focus on what is being, I'm hearing, lessened, almost like, I'm hearing lock and keys here with the Devil in reverse. For a number, you could be liquidating, or you could be moving out of a certain space. Again, someone could be stepping down from a certain position. Someone could be moving out of an actual space. You could be thinking about, how am I going to be moving my assets as well into another space? And that, there could be a question of, I'm almost seeing someone being like, look, I want to invest in another space, but you've still got perhaps some form of investment in another space, and you're like, I want to kind of move out of that space. I want to move into that space. How is it that I'm going to make I'm hearing the jump here. I'm hearing with the tracksuit and the pants on here. I'm hearing Tyler. I'm hearing, again, tailored with the tie, with the Fool. I'm almost seeing someone with, like, it's interesting. I'm almost seeing somebody who's wearing some kind of, like, getup, okay? They've got this, like, outfit on. I'm hearing razor blades. I'm hearing razor sharp. Like, I'm seeing a chiseled beard, mustache. I'm seeing something of, let's say, I'm hearing GQ. I'm hearing lady. Very interesting. I'm not sure what that might mean in particular. I believe that's is that a magazine? GQ? Okay, but the Fool is at the apex of here, this devil, and I'm seeing that there is a sense of commitment here. Even as early, I'm hearing the early bird gets the worm. I'm hearing specifically early riser here with the Fool. There is a feeling of I'm hearing wanting. I'm hearing also desire. I'm hearing winning, a sense of moving forward in a certain direction. But the question may be of, well, what exactly is it that we are going to be, I'm hearing taking out, I'm hearing down the line from what it is that we are taking forward to this first, I'm hearing step and stage that we're moving through. I'm seeing that this is something that it's interesting. Let me say it in this way, that it's almost as if I'm seeing someone applying, let's say, to work for a certain business, a certain company, and it's almost as if the company is going to be, let's say, changing, I'm hearing transforming, like almost going to, there's the understanding, let's say, that the company's going to get bought out within, let's say, 3-4 months, I'm hearing August, September, November, I'm hearing as well, October, I'm hearing iffy, okay, but I'm hearing Jiffy as well, I'm hearing Jiffy Lube here, with the Fool, the Father of Wands, and the Devil, I'm hearing, but I'm hearing dilate the pupils quite yet. Okay, interesting. I'm seeing don't determine. I'm hearing the algorithm quite yet. There's something that is being still. I'm hearing fixed here. The Seven of Pentacles, the Four of Pentacles, the Devil's in reverse, the Death card is upright. There's something that still has yet to be perhaps even physically moved over. And I'm almost seeing someone like, I want to buy this house, but I'm still in this other lease. It's like that kind of feeling. I'm seeing someone showing up to an interview, okay, and being like, I'm still in my other contract, but I am so clearly here. I'm hearing in heart and spirit. Very interesting. And there might be, I'm hearing a readiness here again. I'm hearing impromptu, I'm hearing visit as well here with the Fool. There's this, perhaps this sense of, I'm hearing commitment. Again, I'm hearing specifically, even if, and I'm hearing even although, there might be still a sense of conversation around that space, okay? It's interesting with the Fool and the Devil here. But, and whoever else might be involved in whatever way that might be meant for you, Three of Cups coming through in reverse over this Death card upright. Father of Wands could be dealing absolutely with a Scorpio, Capricorn, I'm hearing, who loves to hold conversation in ways that are really, like, freaking convoluted, okay? And that's a very Scorpio thing. Can be. But you do have the Ten of Swords mirroring here. I'm hearing the mask of I'm hearing the Sagittarius who plays like a Scorpio. I'm not sure, again, what's going through. Libra. But you could be dealing with, a Scorpio who's got, I'm hearing beady eyes. I'm not sure, again, I'm hearing beady little eyes. I'm not sure what that might mean. Again, here with the Two of Pentacles, like someone who, aha, okay. Libra, you could be dealing with someone who is an auditor. I'm hearing specifically somebody who is also, I'm hearing through conversation is a communicator. Okay, what does that mean? It's almost like they communicate through their words. I'm hearing through the words that they communicate through. It's almost as if to say it in this way, I know it's a bit abstract, Libra, but to say that there are a lot of layers here that are being, I'm hearing lifted here with the Ten of Swords in reverse, the Death card upright. But I'm seeing that it can be happening in a number of ways. Almost like, well, when I'm talking to this individual, what's being, brought out. I'm hearing from my end and from, this could be a negotiation for a number of you, okay. And it could be an analyst financially. Okay. Even, I'm hearing an interpreter. Somebody who also, interesting. Very interesting. Somebody who is involved in, okay, an investigation. Okay, an investigator. I'm hearing specifically. Someone who works with, and they could be related to a certain, I'm hearing pool of assets. I'm hearing party. I'm hearing party three, the three of cups in reverse. Okay, nonetheless, Libra, again, I'm seeing that there is a focus on what is being eventually, I'm hearing, brought out. And that, I'm hearing, is a mission that we're drawing to scale. And it has a number of different steps along it that we feel we perhaps need to be, I'm hearing, soldering to the ladder itself. Very interesting. I'm almost seeing like rungs that you're taking out, and you're like, we gotta tell the clock how to tell time again here with the Eight of Wands and the Ace of Pentacles. Okay, for a number of you, this is something. Let me tune in here 1 second, Libra. Okay, let's backtrack. There might be something that you are, again, wanting to almost like bring into fast forward. I'm seeing it in that way with the High Priestess and the Hanged Man, the Fool as well. There's something that you see. Libra, you know, I'm hearing what the curtains really open to when the window is in full view. Okay, let's say it like that. The feeling is that as strong as this vision may be, there is still a physical counterpart, I'm hearing, to the manifestation. It's almost like, how do we get the clock to tell time at the speed that we want it to? I'm hearing that also we tell it to. Very interesting. And there is a focus on what will eventually be carried out, I'm hearing, through a managerial role. I'm hearing that for a number of you related here to the Magician, something that perhaps you see also guiding a number of other individuals through. I'm hearing light bodies here. Love and light to you, Libra. Thank you so much for tuning in, all of you. Thank you so much for connecting. Thank you all so much for tuning into you. And thank you so much again for your patience with this reading, for your likes, your comments, your shares, your subscriptions. I'm so touched by all of you. Love and light to you here. And I'm seeing for a number that you are connecting to someone who you really, I'm hearing, you miss them. It's been a long time, Libra, whatever that may mean, in particular for you. Okay, and it can be related to Sagittarius, and also I'm hearing people from the Catskill Mountains. I'm not sure what that might mean. Again, it could be even a community as well that you might be connecting to, even in a state of meditation. Okay, and I'm hearing singing here with the High Priestess. Very interesting with the Magician. Focus on meditation strongly, so as well as I'm hearing the vision that you hold. I'm seeing you having absolute I'm hearing comfort in the space of how you see yourself, and I'm hearing the understanding of how you see yourself carrying this dream forward. Okay, Libra, thank you so much again for tuning in. Love and light to you all here. Have a beautiful February, and I'll be coming through soon, hopefully within the next few weeks or so, with the moon cycle readings. Okay, so for those of you who might not already be subscribed, again, if you'd like to get notified exactly when the readings post, feel free to click the subscribe button via the button at the base of the reading, and that will lead you to subscribe. And if you'd like to get notified, though, again, of exactly when the readings post, then feel free to click the the bell icon. Okay, and that's how you get notified. Thank you so much again for tuning in, Libra. Have a beautiful February, and I'll see you soon.